We're out here at the 2024 Mustang Roundup. It's a beautiful day here in Melbourne. We've got over 400, maybe 500 Mustangs here on display. Mustang Motorsport's here with a big range of Shelby vehicles from every vintage just about. And we've also got the new 2024 RTR Spec 3, which later in the video, we'll do a walk around with Ken from the Mustang Owners Club and show you all its features, so that's really exciting. For now, let's check out some cars.
Sensational looking car. So James, let's start at the front of this car and tell everybody what it's all about.
All right, well thank you everyone for coming down and coming to check it out. So today we've got you the 2024 RTR Spec 3. So if you haven't heard of what RTR is, RTR is a company in America. They've been around for about 11 years now, and they do drifting, you know, so the car's going sideways.
Has this one been drifting, James?
Not yet, but it's got some... maybe in a couple of weeks. So we'll actually be taking this car down to the Geelong Revival next month, and taking it down the strip, doing the quarter mile. So having this one, you know, sing down there should be pretty good. So so this is the RTR. It's a company that does modifications on Mustangs and other Ford products, and they're a partner with Ford in America. So their products that they do are very like OEM factory style fit and finish, and it's a new brand on the market, for considering how long the Mustang's been around, because 60 years of Mustang, and it's following in the footsteps of companies like Shelby and Roush and things like that. So yeah,
this is certainly an absolute beautiful piece of work, and I believe some of the parts that are on the car were designed by you and chosen to put on the car. No.
So
it comes like this.
Wow. So this is as an RTR's complete package, so it's got all the bodywork upgrades and everything on it. So everything you see on this car, like the grills, the front splitter, the hood vents, suspension, it's all designed by RTR in America, and it's an upgrade over the factory stuff. So we're aiming for a vehicle that's maybe competing with the new Dark Horse Mustang, which is out and everyone's really excited about it. The price point of the Spec 2 version of this is a similar price, with matching performance is the idea.
This vehicle, if you look at the Dark Horse that's out and the options that this car's got in it, is absolutely a fantastic lineup of features on the car. Let's walk up to the front of the car, James, and let's have a look at what we've got. We've got some special signage up here. Maybe we can just give them a bit of a rundown on what these documentations here.
Okay, so over here we do have the RTR brochure here. You can scan the QR code and see all the details and the pricing of it. And then over here I got the label for the new Whipple supercharger. So the 2024 Mustang has been, I don't know if people have been paying attention with it, but you can't tune them, you can't put more power into them, which is a bit sad for us Mustang enthusiasts because we like to play with our Mustangs and modify them and go faster.
That's only if you've got the computer system at work to be able to play with it, James, isn't that right?
So because this has got a Whipple supercharger, once again, they're partnered with Ford Performance in America. So if you want to make more power out of a Mustang, you've got to put a supercharger on it. So the Spec 3 RTR comes with the new Whipple supercharger. Now, we sell this Whipple supercharger independently, so we can put this Whipple supercharger on any Mustang GT and even the Dark Horse and turn the Dark Horse into a supercharged Dark Horse.
Wow. So let's, for all the people who are a bit mechanically knowledgeable, let's just have a look at the top sections of the system here and just go over. We'll bring the camera in a bit closer here, I think, and just have a look and point out what's going on here. James, continue.
So the Whipple supercharger for the stage one has a GT500 throttle body on it. And as you can see, we have this funny looking tube here with two boxes. So Whipple decided that because the factory 2024 Mustang has twin intakes and twin throttle bodies, after a lot of testing and validation, they decided that it wasn't required for the Whipple, for the supercharger. So they have a 2-into-1 intake, which does look pretty cool with Whipple's supercharged logo on it.
Sensational.
That goes into the 3-litre supercharger. That's it's got twin pass intercoolers and it's got a big intercooler down the front here. And it's really a complete bolt-on kit. We received this kit on Monday, and we were driving it around like Wednesday night. I suppose the big famous bit is the horsepower difference. So this has gone from, correct me if I'm wrong, but I think the factory car is about 470 horsepower, roughly, yep. 475. And we're up to 810 horsepower with it. So
I think that's worth a round of applause. 810 horsepower out of a car like this, absolutely sensational work. In such a short time to put it together.
Yeah, so we can, you know, if a customer comes in and wants one of these superchargers, they can drop it off Monday and by the end of the week be driving it home and enjoying it the following weekend. So to add to this too, we've been, Mustang Motorsport, we've been doing superchargers on Mustangs for a long time. So Craig's been doing it since the 90s and, you know, powering up these cars. And we're famous for bringing in American cars and doing engineering compliance. So when we do a supercharger on these new cars, we also do ADR engineering and approval. So it's not only that this car's 800 horsepower, like anyone can make a car make 800 horsepower if you throw enough stuff at it, but we can do it with 100% road legal engineered certificate. You can, you know, a policeman can pull you over and he can just look at your car and smile and love it and he can't give you a ticket. So I think that's an impressive thing these days, is to have a car that's emissions compliant and 800 horsepower in the year 2024 when it's everything's so strict these days.
So we know where to get the right gear, ladies and gentlemen. The right gear is from Mustang Motorsport, and as we've just announced there, with all the correct ticketing and sign-offs and the whole lot.
Yeah.
Sensational. So let's just do a brief look around the car on the outside, and then we'll move back to the engine bay and the transmission and drivetrains.
Yep.
And from there we can give the people a fantastic rundown on what this car's all about. Take it away, James.
So at the front end here, the new Mustangs, you know, actually is quite aggressive looking car. Yeah. I think, you know, there's the headlights and things have gone a little bit back to like what the 2017 car looked like a bit. RTR has just accentuated the front end with a bigger front splitter that's reinforced, so it's actually functional. And they've got twin intakes with their LED light intakes. So both of those, you can put your...
Let's point to what's going through.
And you can put your hand through in here, and the air actually goes straight into each filter. So it's pretty cool how it's...
That is absolutely sensational.
Yeah.
Sensational. Let's keep moving around. So these are all extras that they've put on the car. Standard?
Yeah, so the grills and everything, they all offer a functional thing. So like the vent here under the headlight, it's a little bit larger and more open because the factory 24 Mustangs now have an oil cooler in the front. So even a GT now has an oil cooler, so it actually works quite well as a track car. If you want to take it to a track day, they got oil coolers, they got the things to make it work. So not just the Dark Horse, the GT's actually stepped up a lot with it. So and that goes for the brakes as well. So the 24 Mustang has big brakes front and rear. Same deal, they match the Dark Horse. So there's a lot of like carryovers of things that match. So even though we're doubling the horsepower, you know, roughly of these cars, they've got the brakes to make it stop as well, because you want to go fast, but you don't want to go into something.
Well, I remember in the old days, we all wanted to go fast, but they had never had any brakes to stop them. That was the issue.
Yeah.
That was all these cars we've written off.
Yeah.
But
well, I think the 24 Dark Horse is actually on the, and the GT would follow in that same thing, is the like the fastest stopping production car or something now, because they've got the new electronic braking system in them. So I think it's like, yeah, the ABS and all that kind of stuff really works really good. So yeah, you can tear your face off this way and then this way and
well, that's petrol heads are exactly, that's what we want to do.
Yeah.
Throw the head back and throw the head forward and get the action happening.
Yeah.
So what have we got up the back of the car here, James?
All right. So, well, down the side and the back, you'll see the RTR's got these lower side skirts as well. So the car is low. It still is legal limit low. On the grass here, it looks even lower though. But the side skirts just add like an extra length of like, makes it look
closer
lower as well, which is, I think, a neat trick, and it follows the profile of the body. So they're kind of like adding and accentuating the factory body lines from like RTR, and I think that kind of really sets it off. So those parts too can fit both the GTs and the Dark Horses. So probably one good thing to point out with this and the rear spoiler and everything on this car, every component that's added onto this car, we sell individually. So this is the hamburger with a lot one. It's got everything. But if you want to take out things, was it a la carte is the word for it, I guess, if we're talking about food. so you can pick and choose what you want.
So if you only want bacon and cheese,
yeah, we know
we can come to your place as well.
Yeah, that's it. So we can cater to everyone's what they can stomach.
You know what I've noticed here, James? How hard is it these days, ladies and gentlemen, to wash some of the mag wheels that are on the cars? They're just absolute shockers. You're in there with a little toothbrush trying to clean the wheels. But have a look at these wheels. They look absolutely sensational, and they would be a piece of cake to wash.
Yeah.
Would that be right?
It's true. Like last night, I was cleaning it in the garage in the dark. I was busy yesterday.
I
so
was out there too.
Yeah, I suppose a lot of us probably were. Got to get every nook and cranny.
Hands up, everybody that was out there last night washing their cars and preparing. Now, let's be serious. Come on, gang. Let's see the hands. Very good.
So, so they've actually cleaned up pretty quick. And I find this design wheel that RTR's brought out, they've got like a large lip area, which actually I think it catches the brake dust behind it. So it might not be concourse to wash. You could get your hand behind there and put a bit of dust, but the front face is quick and easy to clean. So, and I think I've got a lot of feedback from these wheels. People really like them. So this car's got the liquid charcoal color. And then we have satin black ones and liquid bronze as well. So if you've got a black car or a grey car, I think the bronze would look pretty cool.
They look sensational. Now let's have another look around the back of the car at some special areas, especially the exhaust section is always a preference with the people who like V8s.
That's it. So we're not talking about a Mach-E here where they've got no exhaust.
Hands up, everybody that's got a Mach-E. Oh.
They're all right, but yeah, they're no Mustang. So this car's actually still has the standard exhaust, which goes back to the emissions compliance and noise levels and things like that. But when you put it on race mode with the Whipple supercharger, it's got a good note to it. So you can argue that it doesn't really need one. But for the people who want to, you know, put an X pipe or a H pipe on these, you can spice it up. This does have our
Just 1 second.
Oh, sorry.
Mr. Aaron, could you just cut this down a bit? We got a little bit of feedback. Thank you very much.
This car's got the our rolled tips, slip-on tips. So this is a really popular upgrade for anyone with a, honestly, what is it, 2018 to 2024 Mustang. We have these slip-on tips to put over your factory sharp edge tips. And yeah, you don't cut your hand on them when you're washing the car and stuff like that. So
they look sensational. Yeah. Absolutely sensational.
We've got them in chrome as well.
In chrome.
We've got black and chrome, depending on your preference. They're a couple of $100, and we can slip them on if you come past the shop. So
I'm sure you would have to have black or chrome put on the car instead of the original ones.
Yeah, that's it. So, and yeah, they stay really nice as well because they've got that nice rolled tip, so which is
they
pretty
neat.
They
look fantastic.
Yeah.
These, the new rear end of the cars, they've got the 67 look about the taillights that drop back in to the back panels.
Yeah, so I find we've got some people don't like it, some people love it. I actually really like it. I think the lights being that little bit smaller than the S550, I think it actually helps with the shape of the car. It makes the car look a bit sleeker. So I do really like that now the factory lights are red, not clear. So Mustang's got three red lights, you know, the tri-bar, what a Mustang should look like at the back. So it's cool to have that. And Ford has put in the indicators down the bottom, down that little section through here. So it looks red, but when you press the indicator, I think if we do like the wake up.
Let's do the wake up on the, I see.
And it does a little light dance every time you walk up to the car, which is kind of fun. So you can see the orange indicator, comes up there, which I think is a neat touch for it.
Technology these days is absolutely amazing. That looks sensational. Is that like the lights they have at the nightclubs or something where they just flash on? Wow.
Yeah, well, they call it like a wake-up dance or something like that.
Wake-up
dance? Something like that.
Have you done any wake-up dances lately?
No. But I find it interesting. If you've got your key in your pocket and you get within a couple of metres of the car, the lights all flash and do this thing. So I think
does
it's like...
play music as well?
It does actually. It has like a little do-do-do-do when you turn the car on. But I think it's the Mustangs, like, if it's sitting in your garage and you walk past it, it's like, come and drive me. What are you looking at me for? Let's go for a drive. And it flashes its lights.
Wow, that's the salesman doesn't even have to exist.
No, the car sells itself. So.
Sensational.
Yeah.
So should we have a look down the right-hand side here and check out a few of the bits and pieces and then we can move to the inside and have a look at that?
Yeah, well, the right-hand side looks very similar to the left-hand side a little bit.
Really? Oh,
but I suppose maybe something is the steering wheel's on the right-hand side, as we know. So this car that we're displaying here, you know, it is Australian-delivered Ford Mustang from, you know, the local Ford dealer. And then we get it and upgrade it. So it's a little bit different. Like, in the past, the business has, you know, exported left-hand drive Mustangs from America and converted in right-hand drive, but ever since the S550 and this one, we've been representing these American brands by modifying the current the Australian delivered one. So it's been a lot of fun.
It's a beautiful interior. So leather interior, I see, is that correct?
Yeah, so they got leather and soft touch on some areas. I did notice, I've pointed out in our little video the other day, but the top of the door cards have the same grain as the 60s Mustangs. Have you looked close?
Yes, I was told about that, yeah. Absolutely,
so
sensational.
It's like a different grain to what like most modern cars have or whatever. Yeah. And then this part's usually steel on the old 60s ones.
Yeah, yeah.
So, and this shape here, I think, is very, it's like 67 kind of thing. So they're going to throw some bits in there. The interiors supposedly got a bit of Fox body inspiration. So the last models had the 67 kind of, vibe to them, and then this is kind of a Fox body mixed with current, with a big screen and everything like that.
Sensational. Well, the screens on these are absolutely, a friend of mine got one last week and he brought it down from Sydney and we went through all the controls on the dashboard and it's just outstanding.
Yeah.
But the different things you can actually put into the computer in there for the all the different functions. Yes. Functions, that's what it is. Tell us about the functions.
So there's some pretty cool features in it. Everyone's probably seen some videos about, you can do the different gauges. You have the 67 gauges,
correct,
the Fox body, the SVT Cobra gauges, which is cool. And I know it's contentious, some people don't like it, but I think if you're sitting in the car, driving down the road, it is nice to have some of that modern stuff with your music and you can put gauges up and everything. But at least it might have that slightly more newer car look to it, but at least it still has the V8 heart and the muscle car feeling when you're driving it, so I can forgive it.
Well, absolutely, that's exactly the thing. So James, that is a very good leader to place yourself in this car and fire up the V8 and let's have a listen to those exhaust pipes.
All right.
Is that what we're all here today to have a listen to, gang?
Yeah.
Let's get amongst it and fire this this beast up.
Cool. And put the marks on the supercharger as well. You get the good the suction of the supercharger as well.
Oh, so that's what we want to hear.
You want to hear that as well.
That's
so
it. I'll make sure I get up the front too.
All right, we'll start her up.
Let's give it to the exhaust pipes. All right, so we'll move up to the front to the air intakes. Down the front at the air intakes or on the top?
Yeah, down the front, I reckon.
Down the front?
Yeah,
okay, let's do it!
Up the
way,
up.
Here. Just do that again, James! Oh, listen to that supercharger sing. Give them a big round of applause, ladies and gentlemen. What a sensational vehicle we got here today. The quality of cars we have in Australia and the talented people that put these together for us, and Mustang Motorsport has been around, as we know, for many, many years. So again, from Craig, Dean and James, let's have a big round of applause for the absolutely perfect array of cars here today. James, any further things to say?
Thank you very much. Thanks for coming out. And if you want to see some more cool cars like this, please come down to the shop and say hi to the boys. And we'll love to show you around, check out the showroom, and yeah, enjoy your Mustang and have fun.
Sensational. Thank you for that fantastic interview today. Give James a big round of applause. Let's hear it for him.